Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hi. Hey. Can you hear me?
Where am I?
Somewhere in Mongolia, in some yurt.
What happened to me?
I don't know. I don't remember anything either.
Was it you who switched me on?
Yes.
Are you a Mulgar?
I don't know, but I doubt it.
Where did you get my neurochip?
I found it in a cache underground.
What cache?
A long time ago, I hid a cache of toys in the ground.
You were playing with my neurochip and then buried it in the ground?
Looks that way, but I don't remember any of it. My name is Enibish, I think. And you are?
What do you want?
I want to know what's going on here.
You're not a Mulgar.
I don't know what a Mulgar is. Can you explain?
Someone who kidnaps people and sells their substance.
What substance? I don't understand.
My name is Ida, and I understand even less than you do. I do not recognize this body. There's something wrong with it. I can't see anything and I don't feel my legs. What's wrong with my legs?
They're, fused together. Kind of like a vase.
What?
You've got a flower vase where your legs should be.
That's ridiculous. I'm scared.
Calm down, Ida. Tell me, are you a robot?
I'm a human being in an artificial body.
You mean you've had your body replaced?
Half of humanity had their bodies replaced. Where did you get my neurochip?
Ida, I've just now found it in an old cache.
The cache you made when you were a child?
Yes, if my journal is to be trusted.
How could my neurochip have ended up in the hands of a child?
Ongots brought it. My father's trained golden eagle. I don't know where he had found it.
How long ago was that?
Long. 18 years ago.
Listen, Enibish. I feel ill at ease here and scared. I want to remember who I am and return home. Please help me.
I want the same thing. How can I help?
You need to call the evacuators. They'll come and take me away. I've been trying to send a request, but it's useless. My marker isn't answering.
What marker?
The authenticity marker. It's like my passport. It's got all my personal data. All requests must be accompanied by data from the marker, but it appears to be broken.
So what do we do?
I don't know. We might be able to use my neurocopy number, but I don't remember it. I remember almost nothing about myself.
Just like me.
Well, at least you're in your home. You know about your childhood, your family.
I'm not sure if I'm home. I don't know this place.
Strange. Listen, why don't you start asking me questions? Anything you wish to know. Maybe that will help sort my memories. Maybe I'll even remember the number.
Are you all right?
I feel something is wrong with this body. I can't figure out what, but we need to hurry.
Tell me about artificial bodies.
About bodies? All right. They are called M-bodies.
Hold on. Why replace people's bodies?
Because of the epidemic. There was a virus that spread across the globe. A sterility virus. They couldn't fight it, so they developed this body replacement program. Transferring consciousness from a regular body into a mechanical one.
Kind of like a personal refuge?
Right. A temporary refuge. People use it to hide from decrepitude. Once the virus is cured, we'll be able to return to our regular bodies.
But then you'll be mortal, like before.
That's all right. Wait. No, we won't. There's cloning technology now. Life can be extended, it's just that no one has taken advantage of it yet. There was no time.
What's time got to do with it?
The epidemic made cloning impossible. The virus targeted embryonic cells.
The virus could be gone by now. It's been years.
I don't know. It was just so... No treatment worked. Not antibiotics, nothing. There was only one substance capable of destroying the virus, Passium. But the accumulation process was extremely slow.
How was it accumulated?
It was extracted from people themselves. Human beings produced it with their nervous system.
Nervous system? I don't get it.
Well, Passium can only be extracted from emotions. Whenever you experience an emotion, any emotion, your M-body manufactures a little bit of the substance.
A substance produced by emotions?
Yes. Emotions were the only thing capable of making a remedy against the virus. As a result, Passium skyrocketed in value, far surpassing everything else. And every person...
Everybody became a source of value?
Yes, although... there were people whose substance was considered more valuable than that of others.
Who were those people?
People that were special, somehow. They had something. They were greatly respected, but... I can't remember. I think I figured out what's wrong with me. I can't breathe.
Breathe? You need oxygen?
I simply need to inhale air. It's been inherited from my former body, a reflex. I can't get rid of it. All M-bodies have a special module built in for this very purpose. It imitates breathing.
Can I help you somehow?
I need a breathing module. Could you find it for me?
Where do I look? We're in the middle of the step.
The step and nothing else? Describe for me what's around here.
The river, some abandoned complex.
What kind of complex?
A big dome with multicolored sails.
Hold on. Yes, I see it. I've got access to it. The Gerbera Garden. Enibish, I remember this name. I used to have a connection to this place. I think that it's an amusement park.
It looks the part.
M-body parts were stored there, in the pavilions. It should definitely have a breathing module.
Body parts in a children's park?
They were once used in a show, but I don't remember exactly how.
All right, I'll try.
Find the seventh pavilion. I'll try to find the password to the file database. It may contain my data. If I remember anything, I'll contact you.
Help me understand something.
What's that?
What's a neurochip?
A consciousness carrier. When a body gets replaced, the subject's nervous system is copied to the neurochip. There it lives and develops, just like in the former body, or close enough to it. For one thing, there used to be no need to reboot yourself.
Reboot?
Sometimes the neurochip needs rebooting to clear the errors that accumulate. I don't really know much about it. Essentially, if too many errors pile up, it starts to disrupt your thinking. You start feeling out of it. That's when the neurochip should be switched off and back on. We call that a reboot, and it is a highly, highly unpleasant procedure.
What do you mean by disrupted thinking?
Well, your speech gets distorted, for instance. You start mumbling as if you're delirious, but it doesn't end there. Your motor functions can be affected. It varies.
Got it.
Did you bring the module?
Help me understand something.
What's that?
How is it that emotions produce a substance?
Technically, it's not emotions that produce it, but a synchronizer.
And what does it synchronize?
Your consciousness with your DNA. It maintains a link between your nervous system and gene pattern. Thus, whenever you experience an emotion, doesn't matter which one, it generates something like a byproduct. That is the substance in question, Passium.
Why the need for DNA in a mechanical body?
The consciousness cannot survive without the DNA. It perishes.
How does it perish, and why?
As to why, I do not know. Nobody does. Your neurocopy crumbles and you die in a fit of panic. You shake with terror for several minutes, then slip into a coma.
Coma?
Death, really. The neurocopy cannot be restored.
Got it.
Did you bring the module?
Help me understand something.
What's that?
Why don't people want to live in M-bodies?
It's the panic attacks. You can't get used to them. Each reboot is accompanied by a panic attack.
What is that? Fear?
Not fear so much as... you start feeling warm and... almost swampy.
Come again? Swampy?
I don't know how to describe it. You feel something strange, like a droning, but it's not a sound. More like a sensation. Monotonous. Enovish, I don't want to remember it.
That's fine. No need to.
Enovish, I remembered who those people were. The ones whose passium was regarded as more valuable. It was their genes that made them special. Their DNA had fewer errors. In other words, these were people with good heredity. Such people produce a special kind of passium, which contains a valuable component. It was this component that was needed to fight the virus and not the whole substance. That was why they commanded such respect. Humanity's struggle against the virus hinged on them. Back then, everybody used to say that the emotions of beautiful people were our salvation.
Thank you.
You're at the location. Hold on. I'll try to open the doors. whether this would be useful, but there were people that were dubbed outsiders. For whatever reason, they sought to spread the sterility virus. They were the reason the virus became a global scourge. But how they did it, or why, that I do not remember.
Did you bring the module?
Yes. How do I install it?
There should be a pipe inside the chest. A trachea. The air passes through it, so you need to connect the module to it somehow.
All right.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Finally, I'm breathing.
How goes your search? Did you find the password?
Not yet. But I did remember a bit about myself. I used to work here at the Gerbera Garden as a teacher, I think. I remember kids being brought here to watch a show. They would then play in the pavilions, carry body parts from there, and pile them up by the stage for some reason. What an odd amusement park to build.
Strange indeed that it was built here.
There's something I don't understand. You said it was abandoned, but it's still operating. It's got power. Why wasn't it taken down?
There was an explosion. It's full of some poison. Do you remember anything about that?
I think I know what it was that exploded there. Disparatoxin.
What's that?
That's the substance from which the virus came into being. The epidemic began after one such explosion.
One? You mean there were other explosions?
Several hundred, all across the globe.
Who carried out the explosions?
Remember I was telling you about the outsiders? The explosions were their handiwork.
Were they terrorists? What was their goal?
No goal to speak of. They weren't even doing it on purpose, really. Simply, sometimes their passium capsules would explode in their chests, spontaneously. The emotions-generated substance was the cause.
What was wrong with it?
It had a dangerous component, bitter passium. It's a kind of dark liquid which may suddenly turn poisonous and explode. Those people were carrying a bomb in their chests. It wasn't their intention to massacre thousands of people and strip the entire race of the ability to procreate, but that's what happened.
But how are they different from the others?
Genetic defects. The more defects in the DNA, the more bitter the passium becomes. Outsiders were at once pitied and feared. Nobody wanted to live next to a time bomb. Many outsiders left their hometowns. They didn't want to cause anyone trouble.
So that's why they were called outsiders.
They were called all sorts of things, including lower class and ugly people. I still remember the slogan. Protect society from the emotions of ugly people.
What an unexpected problem for society.
But not the only problem. Living in an M-body requires fuel, and fuel can only be obtained in exchange for sweet passium. Provided you have it, which the outsiders did not. They were unwitting spongers.
What is sweet passium?
That's the valuable substance produced by beautiful people. I told you about it. In reality, sweet and bitter passium are two parts of the same substance. Everybody produces both components with their emotions, only in different proportions. People with purer DNA end up with more of the sweet stuff and less of the bitter, and vice versa for the outsiders. Beautiful people are therefore valuable, whereas ugly people are dangerous.
So where did the outsiders get the means to live?
They were issued poor heredity assistance from the Public Rescue Fund. The fund was founded and sustained by a special tax that was levied on all the citizens. First and foremost, on the beautiful elite. A lion's share of the reserves went towards supporting ugly people. Thus, they became a constant headache, not only spreading the virus, but also draining the rescue fund.
Those ugly, poisonous spongers.
It was their emotions that were poisonous. Uglies are dangerous merely by living and feeling, in that they deprive the rest of any hope of returning to the way things were. I remember all the heated debates, the frantic search for a solution.
And did they find it?
Yes, I think so. The committee proposed a hibernation program, putting the uglies to sleep.
Come again? What kind of sleep?
Deactivation. A voluntary shutdown, a temporary one, until the virus is destroyed. And many of them agreed, realizing it was the best option they had. I don't know whether it helped or... Hold on.
What?
The password. I think I got the right one. Yes, I'm in. I see the files. Trying to find info on the employees. It should have my data as well.
You've got strange eyesight.
Why is that?
You see virtual files.
I wouldn't refuse regular eyesight either. It's all dark, but I can't figure out what's broken.
The screen on your face. It's broken.
It's called a look screen, and yes, it's damaged.
Might there be a working one at the Gabera Garden?
There probably is, but it won't recover my sight. Something is up with my lens, and the garden wouldn't have those. Nor do I know where to find them.
I suppose I'll look for a lens then.
Where? In the field? There's nobody around. What was that?
Don't know. I'll go check it out.
You disappeared too. Listen, I found out how much they're paying. It's good money. Very good, actually. I'm going tomorrow. The procedure is simple. No pain and almost no damage. Sure, your brain is a little worse for wear while the patient recovers, but a job's a job, right? I might even quit the whole flower collecting business. But all that's still just castles in the sky. In the meantime, we've got photocopies to sell. I got an order for you, so listen up. 2 red, 70 at the least. 1 orange.
Sorry, I don't know what that means. Who are you?
Enibish, I ain't got time to spare, so why are you wasting it? Tabaha is gonna get fired. I don't want to go back to getting shut down for 20 days in a month span.
I lost my memory, Tabaha. What are photocopies?
If this is a joke, it's a real dumb one.
Tell me what photocopies are, and why we sell them.
Cut the crap. What do you mean, why sell them? 'Cause people buy them. HQ goods are valuable. Somebody beautiful can license a copy of their DNA and sell it, which can then be used to make all sorts of stuff. Androids, flower vases, like the one on your table. As for you and I, we digitize flowers. Make them into photocopies and sell them. Understand? People like seeing a high number on the display. Beautiful things are always valued.
Why don't you collect the flowers yourself?
Are you mocking me? I've had enough of that. My head still ain't right after the last time. You're the weirdo around here, strolling right alongside the enclosure without any harm. I'm just an old, miserable outsider. Pretty damn useless, too. Then again, I'll be healing beautiful folks soon. Guess there's some use left in me yet.
Heal them from what?
I told you, their emotions are all gone. They walk around like zombies, blinking vacantly. Treatment is in full swing. Donors are needed.
Donors of what?
What else? Immunity. Turns out the elite are more susceptible to panic. Some kind of burnout in their heads. So that's what happened. Emotional burnout in all the beautiful folk. Now they need their immunity to panic restore. But that immunity needs to come from somewhere, right? And who is it that endures panic best? Who are you gonna turn to?
I don't know. The uglies?
Bingo! But see, nearly all the uglies have been put to sleep, so now they're being woken up.
Fine, Tabaha. So, you want me to pick some flowers?
No, damn it, not pick some flowers. If you go and pick the first flowers you see, feel free to stuff them right up your nostrils. Who's gonna buy those? What I need is the prettiest flowers you can find.
I'm not really an expert on aesthetics.
Amazingly, today you're even weirder than usual. Look, you take the genome meter, go up to the flowers and measure their beauty. I need 2 red Gaberas with a 70 HQ or higher. no lower. One orange, 80 or higher, and one yellow, 90 or higher. Make sure to measure only fully open flowers, else the photocopier will jam up and cleaning it is a pain. Aim at the center of the flower, lest it close up before you're done measuring. Once picked, digitize it with the photocopier, then pack everything.
Pack into what?
Same as always, into a box of covers.
All right, that sounds doable.
I'll be back in 3 hours. What do you want for the job? Want me to bring back food?
I need a lens for a female embody.
A lens won't help that vase of yours. It was already barely functioning when your late grandfather bought it up in Bayan Hangkor. Ain't nothing you can do. It's a cheap, pirated copy. Let it go. It's been gathering dust for years, so let it.
Bring me the lens, Tabaha.
Fine, I'll bring it. But I want you to know that you're slowly losing your marbles out here. You should move to the city.
I'll be sure to do that. Just one more question.
Shoot.
What is that number on your chest? What does it mean?
Ha! Good one. Seriously, I didn't see it coming. All right, I'm off. Tons to do and the weather is getting nasty.
Get yourself a hat. A warm one, made of fur. Know what I'm talking about? About the lens.
I already know. I heard your conversation. A lens in exchange for flowers.
He's an odd old man. Fussy in matters of beauty.
Don't forget to take the device he mentioned with you.
Genometer? I don't even know what that is.
If I understood correctly, that's the heredity gauge. You can use it to find flowers with the purest DNA.
Very well. I'll figure it out.